Yes, Simon. I think probably what finally shook him to bits was the fact that your meat didn't come wrapped up in plastic. It didn't come from a supermarket. It wasn't a ready jointer. He loves cooking. But again, right at the end of the first half, as it were, Culimacare is a great hunter. He always wanted to shoot a tapir. You're not a man until you've shot a tapir. Wonderful things, like a Shetland pony with a long snoot. And I helped gut it, of course, with the Charlie knife. And that sort of horrified Simon. And by the way, I mean, everybody always, you go straight for the liver. The liver is the great delicacy. So they're tearing out the liver, and Simon is groaning in his hammock. And I think nothing of it. And then 2 days later, back in Curimakari's little village, and Chimo sharing out all this meat to everybody, a great, a really great thing. And I go for a pee in the morning, and the childhood nightmare has arrived. Here it is. My penis has gone green. It's a bunch of grapes. The tapir ticks got in up the trousers. Now they're flat, they're big, as big as a man's thumbnail when they're swollen. But they're flat and you don't feel anything. And they'd swarm all over me and into your trousers, and they go for the one place that a tapir will never scratch on a thorn bush, rub itself on to get rid of the ticks. And that's around its penis. And sucks blood very fast. And the expanded skin is green, dark green or bright green, and drops off, goes up and digests this blood meal on green leaves. Simple. So the birds can't see it, or not so well. It's camouflaged. Anyway, the SAS said, ticks, lad, take them off with sellotape. But I'm afraid what you do is you pull them off and scream and stamp on them. Light scarring.